gets a little she knows lazy.
Oh, look how beautiful.
Oh,
no, no, no,
you're a
today is an ordinary day. The sun rose as it began, and the sun will set as it comes to an end. But in the routine of this ordinary day, something extraordinary has happened. Family and friends have gathered from different parts of the world to witness Sarah and Thomas's commitment to one another. Today, their new adventure begins. Who presents this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother-in-law.
Sarah and Thomas wish to let their families, especially their parents, know how much you mean to them and how important you've been to them from the very beginning. As you have watched and guided them and encouraged them to be the people they are today, so you have been there when they found each other. And it is fitting that today they are here before you, as they have always been, to ask you to witness their joining. They ask that you will still be here to guide them, to be there in their difficult times and their joyous ones, to be there for their children, and to give them your guidance too. You see, this marriage is a marriage of family. And Sarah and Thomas acknowledge that their families are now united. Sarah and Thomas, a marriage represents one of life's greatest commitments, but also one of life's greatest adventures. Into this adventure, Sarah and Thomas bring their unique talents, personalities, passions, and their desire to love each other for life. Marriage isn't just about choosing the right partner, it's about being the right partner. It's about speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude, having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is never taking the other for granted. It is never going to sleep angry. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and a sense of humor. It's about never being too old to hold hands. It is standing together and facing the world. And now I ask that you declare your intentions to one another. Thomas, do you take Sarah to be your wife? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, protect her, forsaking all others and holding only unto her forevermore? If so, say I do.
I do.
And Sarah, do you take Thomas to be your husband? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others and holding only unto him forevermore? If so, say I do.
I do.
Before taking their vows, Sarah and Thomas have chosen a quote by C. Joy Bell to express their feelings about true love. You only need one person to love you, but you need them to love you free like a wildfire, crazy like the moon, always like tomorrow, sudden like an inhale, and overcoming like the tides. And now, Sarah and Thomas, you ready to exchange your vows? Thomas, repeat after me. I, Thomas, take you, Sarah.
I, Thomas, take you, Sarah.
To be my partner for life.
To be my partner for life.
I promise above all else.
I promise above all else.
To live in truth with you.
To live in truth.
And to communicate fully and fearlessly.
And to communicate fully and fearlessly.
I give you my hand and my heart.
I give you my hand and my heart.
As a sanctuary of warmth and peace.
As a sanctuary of warmth.
And a pledge of my love, devotion, faith, and honor.
A pledge of my love, devotion, and faith.
As I join my life to yours. Now, Sarah, repeat after me. I, Sarah, take you, Thomas.
I, Sarah, take you, Thomas.
To be my partner for life.
To be my partner for life.
I promise above all else.
I promise above all else.
To live in truth with you.
To live in truth with you.
And to communicate fully and fearlessly.
And to communicate fully and fearlessly.
I give you my hand and my heart.
I give you my hand and my heart.
As a sanctuary of warmth and peace.
As a sanctuary of warmth and peace.
I pledge my love, devotion, faith, and honor.
I pledge my love, devotion, faith, and honor.
As I join my life to you.
As I join my life to you.
Sarah and Thomas, as the two of you come into this marriage, uniting as husband and wife, and as this day affirms your faith and love for one another, I would ask that you always remember to cherish each other as special and unique individuals, and that you always respect the thoughts, ideas, and suggestions of one another, even if it's whose sports team to watch that night. And so, before your family and friends who have assembled here today, and in so much as the two of you have agreed to share your lives together and promise to love each other by these vows and the joining of hands, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Thomas, you may kiss your bride. And now as you turn towards your family and friends, it's my
nice.
Pleasure to congratulate and introduce for the very first time Mr. and Mrs.
John.
Thomas
stop dreaming who you're dreaming of.
have set his heart's too hard to hold. And it takes a little time, but you should see him when he shines. Cause you never wanna let that feeling go. When you love,
ooh, you love.
Stop dreaming.